Hi students, good morning to everyone. So welcome to Tungal online classes. So now we are going to start the new chapter, that is application of integrals. So already we are familiar with integration. So there we learned formulae and the methods of integration and its different the different methods also we learned how to integrate a function. Now we are going to discuss its application. So as already we discussed in differentiation, like application of differentiation or application of differential, like that. So we have already knowledge about that. So there we learned under application of differentiation, for a given curve to find slope, for a given curve to find its slope of tangent, slope of normal, equation of tangent, equation of normal, and for a given function we have to find its maximum and minimum values, and for a given function where it is increasing or decreasing, and for a given function or for a given value its approximate value we have to find out. All those we discussed in application of differentiation. Now here we have to discuss application of integrals. First of all, what is the use of this integral concept? Integral, application of integral is nothing but, here we are going to find area bounded by the curve. So application of integrals nothing but to find area bounded by given function or given curve at particular limits, we have to find the area. That is nothing but application of integrals. So now in definite integral, in the starting of definite integral topic, there we know a definite integral, it is in the form of integral a to b f of x dx. So there we discussed area function, means that a definite integral, it is in the form of integral a to b f of x dx, where a and b are lower limit and upper limits. So here if I took one function y is equals to f of x, the function is continuous in closed interval a comma b. So the function is continuous, continuous nothing but the function should not break in the interval a comma b. So I considered one continuous function in closed interval a comma b. So now this is nothing but represents with x is equals to b. Why it is represented with x is equals to b? Nothing but it is the line parallel to y axis. Whenever it is parallel to y axis, the line, it is the equation in the form of y is equals, x is equals to h. That's why here I written this line equation x is equals to b. Similarly, this one nothing but x is equals to a. Let us take c is any point in the interval. You can take anywhere in this interval the point c. There if you drawn here one vertical line like this, so this line equation is x is equals to c. Now I will say some part here. See the part shaded here, this region or this area of this region or the shaded region, here it is bounded one side. What is this one? Nothing but bounded by the given curve or given function. What is that? Y is equals to f of x. In between the limits, in between the limits, what are that? X is equals to A, X is equals to C. We call it this one as ordinates. Okay, now you can call it as limits or you can call it as ordinates. So this particularly the shaded region is bounded with one side the given function or given curve. What is that? Y is equals to f of x, and in between the particular limits, what are that? X is equals to A and x is equals to C, and with x axis. So this region represents with A of x. In definite integrals we have this one. This, what is this A of x? We call it as nothing but area of function. So this shaded region will get by integrating the given function. What is given function here? F of x. So given function we have to integrate in between the particular limits. What are that? X is equals to A, x is equals to C. So from left to right, A is the least one, C is the greatest one. That's why I take as here A is the lower limit and C is the upper limit. So dx. So this required region or required area of this region will get, that is a formula, integral A to C f of x dx. So it is the application of integrals. One function, if you integrate in between the particular limits, will get the area bounded in that limits, in between that limits. That is the application of integrals. Now consider one function or curve equation, y is equals to f of x, which is continuous in closed interval a comma b. Now we have to find out the region bounded by the curve in between the limits with x-axis. Now this area we have to find out. So here, if I drawn here like vertical stripes, these are called vertical stripes. I drawn here some vertical stripes here. So now any one particular one arbitrary vertical stripe, if I consider, so one arbitrary nothing but wherever you can take one stripe here, the vertical stripe, if I consider, so here this vertical stripe should shade like that. So this vertical stripe area we have to find out. How to find? Here see, this is the small interval, okay, now a small value of that stripe, let us take with dx. Understood? Here I took one vertical stripe here. This vertical stripe has the length here, that is dx, and this vertical stripe has the height, let us take as y. Then this area of this vertical stripe will get, that is nothing but y into dx, length into breadth, like that you treat. So since it is not a rectangle, but we have to treat it as a rectangle, this one. So now area of rectangle, length into breadth. So like that we'll get here area of this vertical stripe as dx into y or y into dx. So now y into dx, y nothing but, what is here is nothing but f of x. So f of x into dx. Now, for this vertical stripe, its area we got it as y into dx. Then, from total, from x is equals to a to x is equals to b, so entire this part area we have to find out. Means that how to write here, nothing but integral a to b y dx, integral a to b y dx, or integral a to b y nothing but f of x dx. Got it? So here the area is bounded with x axis, bounded with x axis, that's why this area. Now observe, so this is the required area. This required area, how to find? Nothing but the given function or curve should integrate in between the particular limits. What are the particular limits here? Nothing but a to b. So required area will get using the formula integral a to b f of x dx or integral a to b y dx. Suppose if I consider one curve, this curve equation x is equals to f of y. Here y is equals to f of x. We'll get the curve equation is like that only. Now suppose consider the curve equation as x is equals to f of y. This function or curve is continuous in closed interval a comma b. The function is continuous in closed interval a comma b. Now this shaded region or this region area we have to find out. The area bounded by the given function or curve in between the particular limits. So what are these limits we'll get? Here if you observe, these lines are parallel to x axis. In previous one the lines are parallel to y axis. So vertical lines these are. So that's why here I written x is equals to b and x is equals to a. But here these are horizontal lines. Horizontal line equation in the form of y is equals to k. Vertical line equation in the form of x is equals to h. Horizontal line equation in the form of y is equals to k. So therefore this is in the form of y is equals to a, and this one is y is equals to b. Now this area we have to find out for a given function or curve x is equals to f of y in between particular limits with y axis. Here the area with x axis, here it is, remember. So while doing problems also, first we have to know how to draw the graph for required question, and then whether the area is bounded with x axis or y axis we have to know. Here in this situation the area is bounded with x axis, but in this one the area bounded by the curve in between particular limits with y axis. Now how to find area? Now we have to observe. Here we can draw here several horizontal stripes we can draw here. Among that we have to take any one arbitrary stripe we have to take. So here observe, so this is one arbitrary stripe we took. This arbitrary stripe, it has the length or width, this one we call it as dy. Here what I took, this arbitrary stripe has width dx, but here what I took dy, and it has the length taken as x. What here I took the length or height of this stripe nothing but y, but here the height of this horizontal stripe taken as x, then what is this area of this horizontal stripe? This is nothing but what you'll get, x into dy. Okay, na? Horizontal stripe, that area will get length into breadth formula we have to use here also. That is nothing but x into dy. X nothing but, what is it? Nothing but f of y into dy. So now, one small horizontal stripe area, we got it as x into dy. Then entire this region area we have to get. So entire this region area, how it will come? Nothing but, so this entire area is bounded in between what the limits? Nothing but integral a to b. Integral a to b, what we have to take? Nothing but x into dy. Here what I took? Integral a to b y into dx. Here what you'll get? Integral a to b x into dy. X nothing but, what is it? Nothing but integral a to b x nothing but f of y into dy. So now in your mind, what you have to remember? Nothing but whether the area is bounded with x axis or y axis, that one keep in your mind. So how to know whether it is bounded with x axis or y axis? Means we have knowledge of draw the graph for required one. So now after that, for a given question, if you drawn the graph, we know whether it is bounded with x axis or y axis. Whether it is bounded with x axis, then use the formula integral a to b y dx or integral a to b f of x dx. When area is bounded with y axis, then use the formula integral a to b x dy or integral a to b f of y dy. Understood? So here first we have to discuss area under simple curves. So simple curves, simple curve nothing but circle, parabola, ellipse, like that you can take. Those are simple curves we are calling. So now area under simple curves. So in that we'll get area of circle. So in lower classes we learned area of circle, what is nothing but pi r square. Area of ellipse, that one actually area of ellipse we'll get in this here only. Means that in lower classes we didn't learn, we don't know the formula for area of ellipse. But about ellipse we discussed in first year conic section chapter. But there we didn't get the formula to find area of ellipse. But in lower classes we learned about area of circle, area of circle phi r square. But we don't have any proof in lower classes for area of circle is phi r square only. But using integration concept we can say, or we know the formula for finding area of circle. So in first year conic section we have circle's concept. So what is area of circle, or means what is equation of circle? Nothing but it is in the form of x square plus y square is equals to r square, or x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equals to r square. So for a given circle, how to find its area using integration? For objective means it is not a problem. So suppose if they given x square plus y square is equals to 16, it represents compulsory a circle equation. what is area form learning but pi r square. What is here r? Nothing but 4. Therefore, what will get? Nothing but 16 pi. For objective, you can do like this. But subjective, using integration concept, we have to find the area of a circle. So now, how to find area of a circle? Now we will going to discuss important 5 marks question, expected one for subjective. So first, in that one, first question, so area under simple curves, under that 5 marks question, expected one. So find the area enclosed by the circle x square plus y square is equals to a square. So question will get like that. So find the area enclosed by the circle x square plus y square is equals to a square. First of all, see here, given circle equation as x square plus y square is equals to a square. It is in the form of x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equals to r square. If you observe, means it is the given circle equation. It is in the form of x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equals to r square. By observe, we'll get h comma k. What is, we'll get nothing but 0 comma 0. What is this h comma k? Nothing but center of the circle. And compare, what is radius? We'll get nothing but a units. So now we should draw here one circle with the center as origin and radius as a units. So figure carries the mark, that's why important. And that diagram should draw with the pencil only in exam, so it carries the mark, that's why compulsory we have to draw. So without the figure or diagram, if you written solution also, it carries zero mark. Remember the students, that's why first of all we have to draw the figure. So here the circle with center at origin and radius as a units. This is the center at origin. Now here I drawn one circle with radius a units. So if it is radius a units, nothing but the point here will get on x axis as a comma 0. The point here will get on y axis as 0 comma a, and the point here will get as minus a comma 0, and here will get 0 comma minus a. Now this area of circle, this circle area we have to find out with a common sense. This one, by observing here, this is the radius will be same only, right? Means that one part if you find into 4 will get the total area, understood? So the total area is here divided into 4 equal parts, right? Why? Because here a units, here a units, here a units, here a units, means that all these 4 parts are equal in area. So one part area if you find, multiply with 4. Why? Because 4 parts are there, 4 multiply with 4 means we'll get the required area of the circle. So now one part area we have to find. So see here, how to find that part area? Same only here, I will draw here one vertical stripe here. That vertical stripe we have to shade. So what is this one thing but dx. What is this one nothing but y? What is given curvy equation? See here, forgot these three parts right now. Our observation is only the first quadrant part only. Understood? So in the first quadrant part, this is the curve. What is given curve or given circle equation here? Nothing but x square plus y square is equals to a square. So now this one, how to write? Nothing but y square is equals to a square minus x square. Y is equals to, what will get? Root over a square minus x square. Why I written like that? Nothing but this curve equation in the form of y is equals to f of x. Understood? So now the given curve, it is in the form of x square plus y square is equals to a square. But how I written? Nothing but it is in the form of y is equals to f of x form we have to convert. So therefore y square is equals to a square minus x square, then y is equals to, will get root over a square minus x square. Next, here this part area we have to find out. So therefore this part limits also we have to know. So what is this limit equation, or what is this line equation? This is nothing but y axis. In straight line concept in first year we have equation of y axis nothing but x is equals to 0. Equation of y axis nothing but x is equals to 0. Next, here we have to know, this is one limit. Understood? There in previous why we have written x is equals to a, x is equals to b. Here this part, first quadrant part, observe, this part is bounded with curve equation y is equals to f of x with x axis in between particular limits. What are particular limits? Means one side we have y axis. What is y axis equation? X is equals to a. One more, what is this one nothing but, will you say, what is this one nothing but? It is at a distance of how much? This one radius a units. Therefore what is this one nothing but x is equals to a. Understood? So here this part, one side bounded with curve equation y is equals to f of x with x axis in between the limits x is equals to 0, x is equals to a. So therefore the required region will get, here we have to write, so required area. So what you will get? Required area nothing but limits. What are that? Integral 0 to a. Formula, what is that? Nothing but y dx. Why y dx? Here the area is bounded with x axis, that's why I took here integral 0 to a y dx. So this is nothing but integral 0 to a y nothing but, what is that? Root over a square minus x square into dx. So if you evaluate this integral, we'll get one part of the circle. So total area we have to find out nothing but, what we have to do? It should be multiply with 4. So 4 times of that part is nothing but total area of circle. So therefore 4 into, so what is this one? Root over a square minus x square. In integrals, indefinite integrals, we have this theorem, integral root over a square minus x square. Formula, what is that? Nothing but x by 2 root over a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sine inverse of x by a. Formula, in indefinite integrals we have integral root over a square minus x square dx formula, x by 2 root over a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sine inverse of x by a. Limits, what are that? Nothing but 0 to a. So now 4 into first upper limit we have to substitute here. If you substitute upper limit here, what will get? A by 2 a square minus a square, nothing but 0 plus a square by 2 sine inverse of a by a, nothing but 1. Therefore sine inverse of 1, this is upper limit substituted minus lower limit you substitute. Lower limit, what is that? 0. So 0 by 2, nothing but 0. 0 into something, nothing but 0 will get plus a square by 2. 0 by a, nothing but 0. Sine inverse of 0, nothing but how much? 0. So 4 into, so what will get? A by 2 into 0, 0. A square by 2 sine inverse of 1, in inverse trigonometric function sine inverse of 1, nothing but how much? Nothing but pi by 2. So simplify, will get pi a square. So what is area of circle formula? Pi r square. What is r? Nothing but here a. So area of circle will get how much? Nothing but pi a square. So this is the method to evaluate the area enclosed by the circle x square plus y square is equals to a square using integration. Understood everyone? Right.